story time. So today's story, I just figured I want to tell y'all the story of my life starting from when I was born. Because basically, I came out of the womb in the streets living my life. So, on this particular day, there I was out there living my good life. And I was living in Providence, Rhode Island at the time. The place was Hartford Projects. Thumbs up if you know that place. So, you know, I was out there playing by myself because I don't know, I may not have acquired friends just yet, which is a little understandable. I mean, you know, you ain't always gonna have anybody to roll with. So I was by myself and I seen this little doggy. And in my mind, I was like, that's my dog. So I'm assuming we had a dog, even though I don't have actual memory of a dog, but I remember my thoughts because I'm the thinking chick. I've always thought I be thinking. So I thought in my head, that's my dog. Let me go pet my dog. So I went to go pet my dog. Turned out my dog was not my dog, and he let it be known when he took me by my face in between his jaws and slammed me down to the ground. Very dramatic. I know y'all thinking, how did I even survive? I don't know, but I remember this like it was yesterday. And so now I'm on the ground face down, and it must have been then that my spirit left my body and flew up onto the branch of a tree and hovered over and watched down. Because it's like I remember this as if I'm watching the event from above the events, right? So I'm down on the ground, my face is down to the ground, so I'm on my stomach, and this dog is standing over me barking. And my mom, she came running out, and she had like a broom in her hands. I know this because even though my face was down, again, my spirit was up there watching over me, and he would not let her get to me. She started swiping at the dog with the broom and got the dog away and got me. And I was in the house, and she was holding a wash rag to my face as she was on the phone talking to my grandmother. How do I know it was my grandmother? Because my grandparents have always been my saviors. So who else would she call if not the most powerful people that I knew of? My grandparents. In her version of the story, she said she was calling an ambulance. But in my version of the story, she called the homies, my grandparents, my saviors. Yeah, so I ended up going to the hospital. And that is the story of, I don't know if you can even see it right now, this scar right here. I don't know if y'all can see it because I got a little bit of foundation on. But I got 6 stitches, only 6 stitches, right there by my eye, and that was my only injury. And I was exactly 2.5 years old. I know I was 2.5 years old because at that time I was an only child, which is why I had no friends, because my mom was about 8 months pregnant with my sister at the time. And I'm about 2.5 years older than my sister. And I want y'all to know that the moral of this story is, I was always a G, right? I was always a G. I mean, clearly I was outside playing by myself because that's how I roll. And I was outside roaming probably the front of my house by myself because that's how I roll. When I rolled up on this dog that I thought was mine but turned out to be not to be mine, and he bit me. But also, to this day, I'm not afraid of dogs. So. I never grew up with a dog phobia or anything. It was just a case of mistaken identity.